Hello and welcome to this demonstration. Today we'll walk you through the process of installing the Unity CSI driver in Rancher. First, let's look at our Rancher environment, where a list of clusters appears. After selecting a cluster, we see the cluster dashboard. A three-node RKE2 cluster is already set up. At the moment, there are no applications or storage configured on the cluster. Let's find a driver in the app catalog. Make sure all channels are selected. We can search for Dell software here. Select Unity CSI driver. On the application page, we can find additional information about the driver, including the prerequisites, the installation steps, and the explanation of the parameters. For the prerequisites, for example, we need to make sure that the software for Fiber Channel, iSCSI, NFS clients, and Multipath are already installed on Kubernetes nodes. In this demo, we'll be using both iSCSI and NFS. The install driver section gives us a brief list of steps for the installation. Basically, we need to create a new namespace for installing the software and its related resources. Additionally, we must create secrets to store the connection and credential information for Unity and the certificates. We can configure the storage class after the installation. After we create these resources on the cluster, we can proceed with the driver installation. Notice that there are links to sample YAML files throughout the page, which I've used as templates for this installation. The installation parameters along with the descriptions and default values are listed below. These values can be customized during the installation process, so please read the documentation for more details. Let's go to Cluster, Projects Namespace to create a namespace. The namespace does not need to be part of a project. We'll name it Unity and won't impose any limits or quotas. Next, go to Storage, Secrets. Select the opaque type. Set the namespace to Unity. The secret name should be Unity-Creds. It's essential to follow this naming convention, and we'll explain its importance later when we reach the installation page. I have already prepared the content of the secret in a YAML file, which we can import here. Ensure that the key name is set to config. The contents of the secret contains a list of Unity arrays, and for each array, we need to specify the global ID of the array, the REST API endpoint, and the username and password. The user must have the appropriate permissions on the Unity array. The global ID, also referred to as the array ID or serial number, can be found in the Unity Unisphere web UI. Under Settings, Software Updates, and System Information. Let's return to Rancher and continue with our task. Click Create. We also need to create secrets for Unisphere certificates. In this demonstration, because we're not using any certificates, we will create an empty secret instead. The secret name should be Unity-Search-0. Now we'll import the empty secret YAML file provided in the sample folder. We're now prepared to install the Unity CSI driver. Let's return to the app catalog. On this page, we also have the option to install a different version of the driver. For this demonstration, we'll proceed with the latest version. In this step, we specify the Unity namespace. The name field is pre-populated with Unity, which cannot be changed. This name refers to the release name, and the secret names we created earlier are based on this release name. Because the release name is Unity, the secrets must be named Unity-Creds and Unity-Search- followed by an index number. If the secret names do not match the release name, the installation will fail. Next, we have the option to modify the parameters in the YAML file. Please consult the documentation for information about these parameters. Here we accept the default values and click Install to proceed. The installation has completed successfully. let's look at the deployment's details. This gives us an overview of what we have deployed on the cluster. We have created several resources. The main deployment consists of multiple controller pods running on different cluster nodes. Now, let's look at the daemon set, where we see three pods, one for each cluster node. Now that the driver installation is complete, we need to create at least one storage class before we can provision any storage with the driver. For this demonstration, we'll create two storage classes, one for iSCSI storage and another for NFS storage. I have already prepared the YAML files for these storage classes and will use the import YAML function to create them. Let's first create the iSCSI storage class. In the storage class, we need to specify the array ID, storage protocol, the storage pool, and other storage features. Please refer to the documentation for more details. Ensure that the array ID matches the global ID in the secret. The FS type is XFS for iSCSI and other block storage types. There's no need to select the Unity namespace because storage classes are cluster-wide resources, like import. Next, let's look at the NFS storage class. It appears quite similar to the iSCSI storage class, with the same array ID, but the FS type is NFS, and the protocol is NFS. It also specifies the NAS server name on Unity. Now we click Import to create this storage class. With both storage classes created, we can now begin provisioning storage from Unity. To demonstrate the provisioning of persistent volumes from Unity and their use with the application, we'll deploy a MySQL application on this cluster, complete with a couple of persistent volumes. First, let's look at the YAML file. Several resources are defined in this file. A new namespace called MySQL-Unity, a MySQL service, a secret to store the MySQL database root password. Two persistent volume claims will request storage from Unity. The first persistent volume claim uses the iSCSI storage class, and the second persistent volume claim uses the NFS storage class. The following resource is the MySQL deployment, in which a MySQL container will be created and set the MySQL root password. In the volume mounts and volume sections, we have specified that MySQL-Unity-Vol0 and iSCSI block volume will be mounted under the /var/lib/MySQL directory. And MySQL-Unity-Vol1 and NFS volume will be mounted on the /data directory. Let's import this YAML file in Rancher. We can see the status of all the resources being created. Let's give it a little time to complete the deployment. I will exit this field and check the status of the deployment. Click the MySQL deployment. We can see that MySQL pod is running. Let's connect into the pod and take a look inside. We can use the execute shell function to quickly drop to a Linux shell. Here I'm running the df-h command to list all the mounted file systems inside the pod. I can see the /var/lib/MySQL directory mounted on a Unity volume. Also, the /data directory is mounted on a Unity NFS file server. Now let's look at the storage reported by Rancher. We can see the two persistent volumes listed here. If we check the Unisphere UI, we see that these volumes appear under the storage section. The iSCSI volume can be found under storage block section, while the NFS volume can be found under storage file section. We can see that the volume names in Unisphere and Rancher correspond with each other. So we have successfully installed the Unity CSI driver in Rancher and installed an application using persistent storage from Unity. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching.